In this chapter, we'll start to add interactivity to our holograms by representing gaze. Gaze is really the user's attention, where they're looking in the world around them. And we'll use gaze to figure out what hologram the user intends to interact with. Go ahead and minimize Visual Studio and close the build settings dialog if it's still open. Now, the first thing we're going to do is add a cursor. The cursor will let the user know where their gaze actually is, so they can be confident they're interacting with the hologram they intend to. To do this, we're going to add the cursor asset to our scene. Go ahead, in the holograms folder at the bottom, in the project pane, click the cursor asset, and drag it up into the hierarchy pane, at the root level. Now, double-click on the cursor to take a closer look at it. You'll see it's a red circle, and it's currently flat, facing upwards. To make this cursor move around every frame, we're going to add a script to it. We're going to use C# scripts throughout this project. Scripts let you initialize objects, and they also let you update how they behave once a frame. To do this, we're going to go to the Scripts folder, right-click on it, go to the Create menu, and choose C# script. Name the script World Cursor. Don't type CS, Unity will add that for you. And make sure you match the capitalization that you see here. Once the script exists, go ahead and drag it onto the cursor object in the hierarchy. You can then click on the cursor object, and you'll see the World Cursor script over on the right. Now, double-click on World Cursor on the bottom in the project pane to load up that script in Visual Studio. Copy and paste in the contents of the script from this chapter. So what we need to do each frame is do a ray cast into the scene to figure out where the user's gaze is. When we figure out where that gaze point hits one of our holograms, we want to take the cursor and place it there, and then make sure it's oriented outwards so that it looks like it's hugging the surface of the object. To do this, we grab the mesh renderer on start, and then the update method, which is called each frame, is where we'll move the cursor around. We get the camera's position, this is where the user's head is, and we get its forward vector, this is where they're looking. We feed that into the raycast. If the raycast hits a hologram, we turn the renderer on so that the cursor renders. We then take the cursor and position it where that hit occurred. We also then rotate the cursor so that it's pointing out. And if the raycast misses, we disable the cursor. Go ahead and click Save All. Minimize Visual Studio, and then build your project as you did before by going to File Build Settings and clicking Build. Select the same app folder. Once the project is generated, go down and open the copy of Visual Studio that you used previously to deploy the project, and click Reload All if that appears. Once you're here, go ahead and click Play again to deploy to the Hololens Emulator.
This time in the emulator, you'll see your scene with the additional gaze cursor. As you drag around to look around the scene, you'll see the gaze cursor moving and hugging the surface of your objects.
In this chapter, we visualize the user's gaze using a world-locked cursor. In the next chapter, we're going to take that gaze and turn it into action by using gestures.